Hey guys, welcome back to Basant Kitchen. Today we are doing my favorite recipe. We are making gobi chicken. It is simple, it's traditional, and it takes you home every single time. So without any further ado, let's get started.
Let's go over the ingredients really quick. We're gonna use 6 chopped tomatoes, 3 chopped onions, green chili, ginger, 1 cup whipped yogurt, 1.5 cup of oil, chopped cilantro. We have our dry spices, salt, garam masala, turmeric, coriander powder, red chili powder, dry methi, vinegar. And for chicken, we're using about 6.5 pounds of boneless chicken thigh meat. And I am using extra large cauliflower heads, 2 of them, chopped. But we're gonna make the cauliflower separate and we're gonna make the chicken separate and then we're gonna put them all together. It's simple, it's awesome, it's Basant style. And before I forget, I'm gonna put all the measurements in the description. So no worries, I got you.
I'm gonna boil the cauliflower separate and you put 2 tablespoons of white vinegar in the water. And the water is nice and hot. I'm just gonna add cauliflower in it. You don't wanna overcook it. Just bring it to the first boil and we're gonna let it rest. Okay guys, cauliflower is ready. I'm gonna use my ginormous spoon / strainer to... So I have the colander on top. So what it does is it drains the excess water out and all you have is just cooked cauliflower. And look at the beautiful white color on it. That's from the vinegar that we add in it. All right guys, the onions are ready. The color is gorgeous. Now we're gonna add the chicken. And we're gonna brown it and then we're gonna add garlic ginger paste. That's one of the ingredients I forgot to mention in the beginning. So we're definitely adding garlic ginger paste. So very gently, we're gonna saute it. About 2 tablespoons of garlic ginger paste. I like 2.5. And so we're gonna do about 1.5 red chili tablespoon, 1.5 tablespoon coriander powder. I'm gonna do 2 salts. We're gonna add cauliflower. And 1/2 teaspoon turmeric. We're gonna saute it really quick. Let the spices soak in. And then we're gonna add tomatoes and yogurt. What I like to do is I like to saute the spices with the chicken first and let the oil separate. And then we add tomatoes and 1 cup whipped yogurt. Okay, so we're gonna saute it good and we're gonna dry out the water from the tomatoes and yogurt, separate the oil from the mixture, and add cauliflower. You see the color is gorgeous. Everything is breaking down. Tomatoes are breaking down. We're about halfway done. So you make sure you keep stirring the pot side to side, very gently. Don't push it around hard so you start breaking the chicken. Let the steam escape. This is it guys, you see the masala and the oil is separated uniformly. Now this is where you go to the next phase. Not before that, now where you have bubbles in between. Now you see, it's completely separated. Now what we're gonna do is, we're gonna put our parboiled cauliflower in. Okay, so now what we do is, just saute it, mix it side to side. So I'm gonna add the green masala now. Take dry methi, about 1 pinch. Squeeze it. Mix it in. And 1/2 a tablespoon garam masala. Or a little bit more. And now very gently mix it all in. And let it sit. Guys, so after we were done cooking, I let it rest for about 10 minutes. I want you to see, because if you can see it, I'm pretty sure you can smell it, because you could just smell the garam masala and the gobi and the dhania in it.
oil is separated. It looks gorgeous. And the chicken, wow. Gobi, it's perfect. Now I'm gonna start plating.
Guys, everything is ready. Now we're gonna move on to my favorite part. We're gonna plate. I'm gonna show you some condiments. We're gonna serve some rice, dal, and some roti. It's awesome, it's perfect. It's definitely Basan style.
I'm gonna put the star of the dish right at the corner of my board. I want you to come in and look. Amazing. So wow. I'm gonna put the sides on the side. We have a little yellow dal. We have a little rice peel off. I'm gonna take the roti. I'm gonna start planning the salad. Need the onions first. Butterfly the tomatoes. Stack them out on the side. I never overthink plating. You just put the colors together and somehow everything just comes together. That's a hot salad. I'm gonna season the salad with salt and pepper. My kind of salad. I have gobi without fresh ginger garnish on it. I like to julienne them really thin. So just gonna drop some green chilies in to bring color. Time for my favorite garnish, dried parsley. Just makes everything come together like the last missing piece.
This is it, guys. Everything is ready. The food is plated. The roti looks perfect. I have a little rice pilaf, yellow dal, and a gorgeous deconstructed salad. And the star of the show is my chicken gobi. It's presented gorgeously. It smells amazing. This is it, guys. This is the best food I cook. This is the food I love cooking. Something that takes me home every single time. I hope you guys enjoyed this recipe because I had a great time making it. Please remember to like, subscribe, and share, and we'll get you guys next time, Basan style.
I'm gonna take it from the spoon.
Awesome. Oh. So good.
Wow, my mom's gonna be so proud of me right now.